So now we're going to learn about quaternion algebra. Quaternions are really a remarkable mathematical construct, and they were developed, credited to Hamilton. Hamilton had the biggest influence or effect on the development of quaternions, and he was in Dublin, Ireland, and had been struggling with the idea of how to combine scalars and vectors into a single mathematical construct. He thought that there was a way to do that, and the associated algebra that would go along with that. And so it was 1843, he was crossing a bridge with his wife and had this moment of enlightenment that was so impactful that he actually stopped to write the equation or carve it into the bridge. And that equation that he wrote down was I squared equals J hat squared equals K hat squared equals I hat J hat K hat equals minus one. And we'll come back to that equation here in just a little bit, and you'll probably understand it better at that point. But anyway, quaternions he felt like were a really important discovery, and they are. They were able to bring vectors and scalars together. Since then, physicists and mathematicians have gravitated towards other mathematical constructs that are arguably more effective for some of the things that they're looking at. And so quaternions kind of lost, or didn't really catch on, I guess I should say, until about 50 years ago or so, when they began to be used in computer simulations. And they are really, really effective for representing objects and their orientation relative to another coordinate system. And so this is used in computer graphics and many modern computer applications. So anyway, they're widely used. And so this is how you define a quaternion. I'm going to put those kind of brackets around the Q to represent that that's a quaternion. And it's defined as some scalar plus some value in the I-hat direction, plus a value in the j-hat direction, plus a value in the k-hat direction, okay? So it truly is a scalar plus a vector here. And Hamilton felt like he had kind of bridged this gap. We talk about our space being three-dimensional. We can define an object in space in three dimensions, and time is actually a scalar. And so he was able to kind of bring this idea of space and time together into a single variable that could represent something in space and time. So anyway, but it's literally a scalar added to something that looks like a vector. So let's start off with something kind of simple in the algebra world here. We'll just talk about addition and subtraction. Okay, so addition and subtraction actually works just the way that you would expect it to. So if we have one quaternion plus another quaternion, so we have A plus B, what that would be equal to is the scalar components A naught plus B naught, and then plus AX plus BX in the I-hat direction, plus AY plus BY in the j-hat direction, plus az plus bz in the k-hat direction. Okay, so we can add two quaternions together just component-wise. We can also subtract them component-wise. You just put a negative in here instead of the addition. And so anyway, add and subtract is really simple. It's just kind of how we would expect. But now let's move into something that is maybe a little bit different, and that is multiplication.